Thank you, everybody, for coming to the Aaron Torres Podcast YouTube page. I do have one quick favor before we get to the video that you came here for, and that is very simply this. You see that little red subscribe button below this video? Go ahead, smash that subscribe button. It really does help me. It really does help this channel grow and my audience grow. So go ahead and hit that red subscribe button. And now, here is the video that you came here for. Let's get into the topic of the day in college football, which was frankly really the topic of the week, and that was National Signing Day. Talked about it a few days ago because really the big topic that came, the big story, if you will, that came out of National Signing Day was what happened at Alabama, where they put together maybe the single greatest recruiting class in the history of college football. So as I said, for everybody who wanted the Alabama Death Star to go down, it ain't happening anytime soon because they just signed arguably the single greatest class in the history of college football. And I don't even know that it's arguable based on the recruiting rankings, who all basically say this is the greatest class ever. But I do think there was another topic that kind of popped up over the back half of the week that is getting a little bit brushed under the rug and needs to be addressed. And that is what happened at the University of Michigan. Because as bad as the regular season ended, as bad as the regular season was in general, finishing 2-4 overall, it was actually a very nice close and a very nice week for Michigan football in general. They closed the 2021 recruiting class with a bang. They opened the 2022 recruiting class with a bang. And I got to say, is it possible that we finally have some positive momentum in Ann Arbor? Not saying we're going to beat Ohio State tomorrow, but is there some positive momentum in Ann Arbor? And I think the answer is absolutely yes. So let's get into what exactly happened, and let's start with what happened in this 2021 recruiting class. First of all, as I mentioned, got a couple big flips late on National Signing Day. Rayshon Benny, who, depending on which recruiting service you go by, independent of it, one of them has Rivals has him a little bit higher than 24/7 Sports, but the bottom line remains, this kid is a defensive tackle out of Michigan, was committed to Michigan State, a four-star caliber player, and he flipped on National Signing Day to the Wolverines. Always a great thing. Is he a program-changing player? Probably not. But again, when you can get a four-star caliber player to flip from one of your rivals in-state and keep him, at home and at the University of Michigan, that's a win. They also got another kid to flip from Texas who was originally committed to Colorado, another defensive lineman. Again, is it a program-changing recruit? Of course not. But when you add those two guys in with the fact that Michigan got Donovan Edwards, who was another star player out of the state of Michigan, to flip right before the first signing day. I don't know if he technically flipped, but he was leaning towards Alabama for much of his recruitment. He ends up at Michigan, and bang! You really did end this recruiting cycle really strong with two or three difference makers potentially, including, as I just mentioned, Donovan Edwards, who signed in December, but for most of his recruitment appeared to be leaning towards going to Alabama. The fact that two of those three guys are from the state of Michigan certainly doesn't hurt. It was not a place that you wanted to start losing recruits from. In addition to that, in addition to those two guys, beyond those two guys and those three guys overall that flipped or committed late in 2021, heck of a start to the class of 2022. Friday, some great news for the class of 2022, where two players, both ironically, not ironically, but interestingly, from the state of Tennessee, commit to Michigan. Taylor Groves, four-star safety, commits to Michigan. And Cody Jones, a four-star athlete from the state of Tennessee, commits to Michigan. And it's a great start to the class of 2022. And so as I look at what is going on at Michigan, it's what I said a minute ago. We are coming off a disastrous 2-4 season. We are coming off a historically bad year where you don't play Ohio State, you don't play Iowa in that final game of the season, you don't go to a bowl game. It's negative, 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 negative. And I think that for the first time in a long time, there's finally some positive vibes around Michigan, and I'll take it a step further. The fact that you got all of these kids to commit after one of the most disastrous seasons in recent history at Michigan is an incredible testament to the new staff that Jim Harbaugh has put together, and I think an incredibly positive sign. Because while we won't know until Michigan takes the field next September, next Labor Day, I think this is a great sign that you have all of this recruiting momentum coming off such a bad season. And many of you who are not Michigan fans, you're probably wondering, how did this happen? So let's get into that part too, because I do think it's important. First of all, again, disastrous season. We know how it went. You fire Don Brown, the defensive coordinator, for obvious reasons. The defense was terrible, but really, if you watch the games, everything was terrible. As I joked throughout the season, besides passing, catching, throwing, receiving, tackling, blocking, and defending the pass, they really weren't that bad at Michigan this past year. But in all seriousness, you know, when you make those moves, the thing that Jim Harbaugh did when he decided to come back is I think liven up his coaching staff. Okay, he went younger, he went more dynamic, he went more aggressive, both on the field but also in recruiting, and I think it's paying dividends. First of all, you go get Mike McDonald as the new defensive coordinator. He worked for your brother John Harbaugh at with the Baltimore Ravens the last couple years. To me, I took that as an incredibly positive sign because Jim Harbaugh is a guy that, as you know, he doesn't trust a lot of people. One of the few people in football that he probably trusts is John Harbaugh. And if John Harbaugh is saying this is the guy that you need to modernize your defense, to get it into the 21st century, to not get obliterated on crossing patterns by Ohio State every year, I trust that John Harbaugh is the guy that has the answer that Jim Harbaugh was looking for. But beyond that, it was the coaching staff and the recruiting staff that has come in since then. Maurice Lundquist is a guy that has come in from the Dallas Cowboys, believed to be an elite recruiting elite coach recruiting-wise. Now, he also comes from an NFL system. I think that's a great sell in recruiting, but he's believed to be an elite recruiter. He was the guy behind the kid that flipped from Texas, as well as the two kids from the 2022 class from the state of Tennessee. You also, by the way, have brought in Ron Bellamy, former Michigan Wolverine, as wide receivers coach, and Mike Hart, former Michigan Wolverine, as the running backs coach. And I think those two specifically are very important to the future of Michigan football for a couple reasons. First of all, like I said, one, young, dynamic, fun. The one thing about recruiting that we know is that kids want to play for people that look and sound and feel like them, okay? It's why a guy like Lincoln Riley is so dynamic, why Ryan Day is so dynamic. It's because they're young. They can relate to a young kid. They can go into a household and feel modern, feel fresh, feel interesting in a way that I hate to say it, but I'm just not that sure Jim Harbaugh can't. And so I think that's one reason. And then I would take it a step further beyond that and also say that the fact that both of these guys are Michigan alums matters. And here's why. I've spent a lot of time covering college sports. And, you know, we hear about, oh, Michigan needs a Michigan man. North Carolina wants to hire a North Carolina man to coach North Carolina in basketball, right? Duke, when Coach K leaves, it's going to be a Duke guy that takes over. Well, why is that? It's a great question, and I was thinking about it this week. I talked to Matt Doherty, the former head coach at the University of North Carolina, who also played basketball there as well. And the one thing he said to me is, when you go into a recruit's home, you can sell the university better than somebody from the outside. Not to say that there aren't dynamic recruiters that didn't go to a school, but when Mike Hart or Ron Bellamy goes into a recruit's household, they can look that recruit in the eye and say, this is what the University of Michigan did for me. This is how it changed my life. This is the education that I got. This is what we did on the football field in a way that guys that weren't in the program can't. And so you add those two guys. The impression that it's going to make on players, the impression that it's going to make on parents, I think is going to be a big difference-making kind of deal. And so when I look at how this recruiting class closed, and when I look at how 2022 has started, I think for the first time in a long time, there's finally some positive momentum around Michigan. Not saying they're going to beat Ohio State next year. Not saying they're winning the Big Ten. But first of all, to lock up this class coming off the worst season in school history, I think, or not school history, but in recent history, I think is an incredibly positive sign. But I think when you add in the fact that you may finally have a quarterback with Cade McNamara, if not, you have J.J. McCarthy on campus, he might be the answer. The fact that you did sign some difference makers at the skill position that can, in theory, help right away in the 2021 recruiting class. Donovan Edwards, who I mentioned, running back from Michigan. Xavier Worthy, wide receiver out of California, who's coming in. Christian Dixon, another wide receiver from California, who's coming in. Maybe some of those guys can be difference makers. Maybe Cade McNamara, maybe J.J. McCarthy is the guy. But I'm telling you, for the first time in a long time, it feels like there's finally positive momentum at Michigan, which had a monster week on the recruiting trail.